Howdy. I'm Ron Hauser. I'm an internationally acclaimed artist, and I just want to tell you a little bit about how I got started. Prior to my getting into artwork, I was a marketing manager for 5 major corporations. But the last one I was with, I'd been there almost 25 years, then I had an accident, and I ended up getting retired because I was disabled. So I was kind of moping around the house, and I was sitting there and talking about, just anything and everything, and taking a lot of naps. My wife says, you know, why don't you go downstairs in the basement and paint? So I went downstairs, started looking around, found an old canvas, found some old oil paints, and I decided, well, all right, I'll see what I can do. Pulled up a chair and started sketching around on this old canvas. And before you knew it, I liked Western things and I liked Native Americans. I've always collected them and I'm a history buff. So I knew a lot about the history of Native Americans and about the West. So I was painting, and finally my wife came down about a month or so later and she says to me, she says, Ron, what are you doing down here? You don't even come up for dinner. And I says, well, I'm doing what you told me to do. You told me to go downstairs in the basement and paint. She says, I wanted you to go downstairs in the basement and paint the basement, not paint in the basement. Well, there you go. Can't get anything right. But she did get behind me. She went out, she bought an easel, she bought me some new paints, some new canvases, and I was off to the races. I started doing more Westerns and more Native Americans, and before you know it, I got written up by a magazine called The American Cowboy. And from The American Cowboy, I was featured down at Silver Dollar City. They asked me to come down, they wanted to look at my paintings, and they bought several of them in prints. And I was there, they asked me to sit and paint, and I did. And I had a very nice time. I've done a lot of commission paintings, and eventually I branched off into different subjects, like the Scottish paintings, paintings on cars, automobiles, planes, dogs, cats, horses, you name it, I painted it. Another unique thing was that we had a little grandson that had been born just right before my injury, and he was on life support and quadriplegic, and to this day he's 14 and a half years old. And he is still on life support and quadriplegic, but he's kind of unique. He rides horses. Now, have you ever heard of that? A little boy on life support and quadriplegic riding horses. He's one of the only ones. I've devoted my time to him and also to raising funds for organizations like Therapeutic Horsemanship out in Winsville, Missouri. There's some unique things about riding horses, and it's very therapeutic for children that have back problems and bone structure problems.
This is a memorial for my grandson, Christian James Miller, born January 15th, 1999, and was called home September 15th, 2017. The following is a Channel 9 TV special that was put together to give a tribute to Christian's wonderful celebration of life.
And the story of an artist and the grandson gone too soon, and what each did for the other.
Christian could bring out the best in people. He really did. He brought out the best in me. And I knew what I was probably going to do.
Great to see you, Ron.
It's all next on Living St. Louis.
I'm Ruthie Zell at Treehouse of Greater St. Louis in Wentzville. This is where our story ends. It begins at an art exhibit in downtown St. Louis with a painter at his easel. And as you'll see, this story took a different direction from the one we originally envisioned. Ron Hauser was engrossed in his work when we first met him in 2017 at his exhibit in the Missouri Athletic Club. The themes of Hauser's canvases largely revolve around the Old West, sports, and history.
And this man right here, King Louis IX, he was in charge of really developing the Renaissance and bringing it to Paris.
Hauser came to our attention when we learned about a workshop he had planned to guide young artists in how to market what they create.
There's so many young artists out there that just, they do beautiful work, they have nice things, but they don't have the clue of the first thing they need to do to get out and start selling their product.
And this is my traveling art gallery.
One of the ways Hauser sells his products is at arts and crafts shows, like the annual Festival of the Little Hills in St. Charles.
Come and look here and I'll show you.
Hauser has his methods for standing out in a crowd in a venue like this. The trailer he uses to transport and display his paintings is a billboard on wheels.
You can see this was a gallery. And this particular case here, I do bronze sculptures too. And I had my bronze sculptures displayed in here.
Health issues forced Hauser to cancel his art marketing workshop, so we put his story temporarily on the shelf. Then a few months later, we visited an art class he teaches in the evening at St. Charles Community College.
Try to work on some of that magenta, the darker magenta now in here, and then your lights.
Hauser teaches painting with the grid method. In a nutshell, grid lines are drawn on a photo or other image the artist wants to reproduce. Corresponding grid lines are then drawn on the canvas or other work surface. With the first grid is a guide. A sketch is drawn over the second grid, followed by the artist's brush.
There's a reason.
In our conversations with Ron Hauser, we always heard anecdotes about his beloved grandson, Christian Miller of St. Peter's. It is Christian's story that ultimately became the focus of this story. Christian was born in 1999 with a very rare genetic condition that plagued his entire body. His extremely weakened skeletal and muscular structures stunted his growth and left him a quadriplegic. Damage to Christian's windpipe made him reliant on a respirator and made normal speech impossible. But he did develop a set of sounds and facial expressions that helped him communicate with family and friends. Christian's grandfather played a big role in the round-the-clock care the boy needed.
Christian could bring out the best in people. He really did. He brought out the best in me. As a grandfather, I probably got a little closer to Christian than most grandfathers would do because I got to be in his day-to-day care. I got to see him at moments where his life was in my hands, which would just scare the living daylights out of you. I got to see him at his finest. I got to see his sense of humor. I got to see the joy that he brought to people, that he put a smile on everybody's face.
Christian's parents, Julia and Patrick Miller, made it a priority to give their son the kind of childhood experiences other kids might take for granted, like sled rides through the snow in the winter. Christian also looked forward to his horse rides at Treehouse, better known as therapeutic horsemanship.
He loved riding horses. Not only did it help him physically, but it helped him mentally. He had a great social relationship with his sidewalkers that were here, and they would physically hold him up until he got too weak, and then his grandfather made him this special adapted saddle, so it was more like a cushioned chair. It had a cushioned back, and it had armrests so he could rest his hands there, and then he still had two sidewalkers. He was never alone on the back of the horse. All the people that worked with him, with Christian and with Ron, his artistic grandfather, were very, very inspired by working with that young man.
Christian became very attached to this old therapy horse named Stoney. Eventually, Stoney died, and Christian became too weak to continue his riding schedule. The boy's condition also made him prone to severe respiratory infections and potential lung failure. though he fought valiantly, the continued assaults on his frail body were eventually more than he could overcome. Christian Miller died September 15, 2017. He was 18 years old. When Ron Hauser learned of his grandson's death, he was vacationing with his wife and some friends in Canada. The news was devastating. On the drive back to St. Louis, Hauser said it rained, it was windy, and the midday sky was nearly pitch dark. Then suddenly the wind and rain stopped, and the sun broke through the clouds, along with a bright rainbow. For Hauser, it was a personal and creative epiphany.
And I told everybody there, I says, Christian's fine. Christian's fine. I said, I can see right now. He's up there. He's riding Stony. He's got Angel with him. And they are absolutely just fine. And I knew what I was probably going to do.
Great to see you, Ron.
What Hauser did was return to Treehouse with a gift, the creation of which helped him work through his grief and honor his grandson. It's a painting titled Over the Rainbow. It depicts Christian free of his wheelchair and breathing tube. He's riding his horse Stony, and running alongside them, Christian's dog Angel, who passed away years earlier. The sunbeam and rainbow were inspired by what Hauser saw on that Canada to Missouri drive.
We are very, very happy that Ron decided to unveil it here at Therapeutic Horsemanship at TH. Christian loved riding, and we loved having him, and we're very thrilled.
So what started as a glimpse into marketing art evolved into paying tribute through art.
We're put here to leave a mark. Best mark you leave is when you're leaving a mark about somebody else.
And that's tonight's Living St. Louis. We like to hear from you, especially story ideas. Shoot us an email or reach us on social media. I'm Jim Kircher. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you, Christian, for all the joy and gifts you have shared with friends, family, and the hope to those who needed you. Keep sending down your beautiful Chrissy Sky paintings that you do so well to make your presence known. Ride high, Christian. Ride high.
Trouble melts like a lemon drops. High above the chimney top, that's where you find me. Oh, somewhere over the rainbow, way up high. The dream that you dare to, why, oh, why can't
So I just want to close with this final thing. If you can think of it, I guarantee you, I can do it. So if you have something in mind and you want it painted, give me a call. And with that said, adios and farewell. We'll see you around.